I am Dr. Iram Khan from Central Institute of Educational Technology, NCERT, New Delhi. Today, we will discuss a topic based on 21st century teacher under the paper Perspectives, Issues and Research in Teacher Education. Now let us see the objectives of this module. After going through this topic, the learners will be able to introduce the attributes of 21st century teachers, groom pre-service and in-service teachers on various attributes of a teacher, discuss the various educational skills and teaching competencies, identify the problems of teacher education in India. Dear learners, we all know that there are many expectations from the 21st century teacher. This teacher has to be a blend of both the old and the new. Indian teachers have been well known for their scholarship. The world at large has been trying not only to emulate Indian teacher, but also the Indian learners. Teaching has been a very noble profession. The teachers have been respected everywhere in India since ages. The 21st century teacher is facing many challenges, such as to be up to date with the latest information by becoming info savvy. At the same time, a teacher has to be a techno-pedagogue. The teachers need to struggle to sustain the cultural heritage of India and prepare for the present and future. This module presents the absolute identity of a teacher, galaxy of teachers, the challenges being faced by the teachers, teaching expectations and expressions, constructivist and connectionist teacher, ICT-skilled teacher, then action research oriented teacher, humane and professional teacher, attributes of 21st century teacher, e-teacher and teacher with multiple intelligences and universal outlook. So now let us discuss about the attributes of a 21st century teacher one by one. The first attribute is that he or she is deeply rooted, which means that the 21st century teacher has to be deeply rooted into the philosophical, psychological, sociological, and historical foundations of education. The teacher ought to have a clear vision and mission with strong determination and action. Rather than stereotyping, she has to be quintessentially innovative. She has to have full self and social sensitivity. The next attribute of a 21st century teacher is being well informed. The 21st century teacher is expected to be well informed in this age of information explosion and media implosion. To be abreast with most recent information, a teacher has to be one on the World Wide Web, that is the fully connected network of networks. Not only being on the WWW or the World Wide Web, the teacher ought to have numerous surfing skills. The teacher is expected to be information expert, that is, info savvy, having competency in various info savvy skills, namely asking, accessing, analyzing, applying, and assessing. For addressing a problem, the teacher ought to be in a position to formulate and flag valid questions and search their answers on the web by employing various surfing skills such as skimming, scanning, skipping, hyperlinking, switching, and full immersion. Then after gathering the information, the teacher should be in a position to analyze whether the information is complete or incomplete, authentic or non-authentic, fact or opinion, old or up-to-date, credible or non-credible, and innovative or primitive. Also, she should be capable of interrelating the data and establishing relationship to inform timely. Having access to information and having analyzed it thereof, it should be applied to the questions raised. Now, the teacher can find that whether the problem has solved fully, partly, or not at all. The next attribute of a 21st century teacher is being well-skilled. The teacher has to be fully skilled on taxonomy of educational skills, such as self-development skills, social skills, life skills, creative and critical thinking skills, thinking training skills, research skills, constructivist and connectionist skills, system thinking skills, information age skills, info-savvy skills, techno-pedagogic skills, digital age skills, open education resourcing skills, leadership, administration and management skills, spiritual development skills, yoga skills, holistic development skills, inclusive education skills, and universal becoming skills. Now let us see the next attribute of a 21st century teacher, which is a holistic teacher. A teacher, though well-founded, fully informed, highly skilled, has to be holistic, where from the ideas spring, feelings flow, motor muscles create, the soul controls, and the self resonates and relates with all unconditional and fully liberated. The teacher ought to be physically fit, mentally alert, emotionally stable, spiritually strong, having interrelation and interdependence with the universe. The next attribute in this line is techno-pedagogue teacher. In this age of technology, any 21st century teacher has to be skilled with principles of technology and that of pedagogy, that is teaching learning, and should be in a position to integrate or interweave these things with compatibility with contents of teaching learning. The various integrations thus obtained should be, the first one is message media compatibility, that is, to what extent a message is medium suitable and vice versa. The second in this line is spatial and temporal contiguity of various messages or forms of messages, that is, various messages in the view composition such as audio, video, text ought to be in the geographical proximity closest are these, better it is. Then the third one is message credibility and media fidelity. That is, the message which is being mediated ought to be credible or authentic and culturally suitable, and the media should be hi-fi, whether Wi-Fi or point-to-point. The next point is media neutrality. That is, the medium which mediates the message ought to be neutral. That is, it ought not interact with the message and let it pass as it is. The next point is media language proficiency. That is, the presenter ought to be fully proficient in the language of the medium or media being employed. It is because every medium has its own language. That is, radio has its own language, TV has its own language, computer has its own language, mobile cell phones and tablets have their own language. The language structures are different. Expressions are different, speed of delivery is different, and reach is different. Now, the next point is message theme, form, and communication control. That is, before sending or communicating, the taxonomy of the text or the message validity. Be it in any form, has to be ascertained. There has to be full control that the message is not released unless its essence is ascertained. The message, media, and modes of communication need to be well integrated. Whether a message is to be communicated one way, directly, through interactive mode or talkback has to be decided by exercising various systems design considerations. Now, the next point, which says that there has to be one-to-one correspondence among sender, message, medium, receiver, and reach. This correspondence needs to be ensured. The next point is media implosion and media choice. That is, in this age of information explosion and media implosion, the media choice has to be exercised very carefully, in such a way that rich and civilized media culture is observed. Credibility and compatibility of the depositories and repositories of educational resources need to be ascertained for their creation and utilization. before one gets lost in the media crowd, the credibility and compatibility of each resource needs to be examined and ensured. Now, the one which we are going to discuss is humane and professional teacher. A teacher should be professing the subject area and be in a position to deploy his knowledge easily, precisely, and efficiently. Teachers cannot be mechanistic, howsoever hostile the conditions may be. The 21st century teacher has to be humane and professional. For this, there are many expectations of the teacher, such as emotional maturity, that is, self-awareness and self-management. Then, social awareness and social management. The teacher should be competent to arrive to the solution of the problems through creative and critical thinking and timely decision making. She should be in a position to easily cope up with the stress and emotions. She is expected to be socially sensitive and throughout the aware of the reality. A teacher has to be the embodiment of all the values and virtues. A teacher is expected to be knowledgeable, skillful, and emotional, holistically healthy and balanced. Humane and professional teachers are rarely found these days. Our Indian ethos is degenerating. Our values, customs, traditions, and culture are fading. We rarely observe the cultural heritage. Orientation in humanistic education is required to enhance the self-concept, instructional mastery, social relationship, and creativity of the teachers. Teachers should be humane and professional both. Now, the next attribute of a 21st century is being absolute identity teacher. We have been constructed through the patience, competence, and struggle of our teachers. Our schools have been and are the learning organizations in the prayer, in the classroom, in the corridor, in the library, in the laboratory, in the play fields, in the dispensary, in the community, everywhere, in every sphere. Teacher is the mother root for all the professions and professionals. Education, the occupation, religion, and profession of teachers is the mother of all the disciplines. All the disciplines emerge from education and merge into education. Saint Kabir once said, "Teacher and God both are standing before me. Whom should I pay obeisance? I bow to you, my teacher, who guided me to God." Alexander the Great, who wanted to conquer the world, said, "I owe my birth to my father, but life to my teacher." The influence of teacher never ends because it affects the eternity. A teacher affects throughout the life. The influence is like a helical spiral. Neither we know its origin nor do we know where it ends. Its spread is infinite. So students, now let us see the next attribute of a 21st century teacher, which is researcher, constructivist, and connectionist teacher. A teacher has to be dedicated researcher because it is expected that the teacher is research-based. She is expected to reason out the never-ending cause and effect relationship and arrive to specific knowledge and comprehensive knowledge base. Along with researcher, a teacher has to be a constructivist and connectionist. She should germinate novel ideas and facilitate germination, incubate, innovate, create, construct, and connect. Every teacher is expected to innovate. Our teachers ought to be pioneers of their fields. They should strike an equation between uploading and downloading. They should be producers as well as consumers. Information and communication technology has revolutionized the society. The living style of each and everyone is being affected by ICT. Education field is not an exception. There is added advantage of ICT in education. The teachers must be aware of all the possible ICTs and know the integration of ICT in education for teaching learning, experimenting, sharing, discussions, and then inclusive education, remedial teaching, and evaluation. The teachers must be holistic by their philosophy and practicality. The learners must be prepared for the life, not for the examination's sake. They must be prepared to design their own solutions and to upload the original productions. Teachers must be creative and constructive, at the same time, connective. The next attribute of this 21st century teacher is being a valuable teacher. Every teacher is expected to be aware of the self strengths and weaknesses. The teacher should go on evaluating her performance continuously. There is no end of knowledge and perfection. The teacher should go on employing regulatory mechanisms for transformation. We as a nation have gone blind to the teacher education norms, inputs, process, and output. Norms and regulations of teacher education are being revised again and again. Despite committees and commissions, the teacher education has resulted into degeneration. We have started disowning the degrees conferred. There is a little quality control on education. The academic performance indicators, or the APIs, are questionable. We constitute expert committees over and above APIs. The entire teacher education, right from early childhood care education or ECCE to higher education and continuing education, has entered into a vicious circle. There should be decent convergence amongst education, society, state, and judiciary. Now let us see the next attribute, which is galaxy of teachers. In the era of Kreta, teacher punishes the student. The student accepts it as a blessing. In the era of Treta, teacher rebukes the student. The student accepts it as a blessing. In the era of Dwapar, teacher requests the student. The student accepts it as a blessing. Whereas in the present era, that is Kali Yuga, teacher stoops at the student. The student accepts it as a blessing. The process of recoil of the teacher-taught relations or teacher-taught relationship needs a lot of research and development. So students, now let us see another point, which is challenges faced and met by the teachers. Today, there are many challenges for teacher preparation, such as manpower planning, developing knowledge base, bridging the gaps between expected thinking skills and competencies, and practiced expected curricula and practiced curricula, matching teaching styles with learning styles, integration of taxonomy of educational objectives and skills, preparation for inclusive education, specialization in emerging areas such as peace education, value education, yoga education, ICT in education. There is an immediate need to groom a lifelong autonomous learner and to evolve child-inspired and not merely a child-centered approach. Choice-based credit system not only ought to be given, but also out of desired and demanded. The teachers are prepared with the past curriculum and expected to prepare the present children for the future. The process itself looks illogical. And there is mismatch between expected and practiced. During pre-service and in-service training, the teachers fight mentally to get adjusted with the newly developed methods and currently running methods. Pre-service teachers were found to be confused initially to find their niche between university-prescribed lessons, designing, and the researcher-introduced approaches, that is ICT-aided constructivist learning approach. The present era needs very competent teachers. For that, the teacher education should be strengthened. The present pre-service teacher education system is expected to provide teachers who are capable of dealing with learners of highly technical, globalized world. Quality education demands skilled and competent teachers. Education is becoming more and more commercial. Educational values and ethos rarely find expression. the commercial people are using the educational institutions for their business. They have little concern for quality education. Teachers and learners, there is mismatch between the subjects taught and the degrees of the teachers. There are parallel private coaching classes. The parents are mad after English language proficiency. The teachers are not updated. The teacher education programs are also not keeping pace with the changing world. Teachers are unaware of the changes taking place in the educational sector. The mismatches between qualification and current profession are causing severe damage. At the same time, a teacher is expected to fit everywhere. Dear students, now let us see the profile of 21st century teacher. The 21st century teacher ought to be master of contents, creative and critical thinker and reflector, self-director, inventor, info-savvy and techno-savvy, and collaborator, a universal becoming and being. The teacher has to be constructivist and connectionist, collaborator and communicator, globally aware and civically engaged, ICT skilled, and financially and economically literate. The teacher needs to be attended to the demands of highly evolved learners, challenging innovators, regulating their energy and power flow, realizing complete adjustment. There is a need to appreciate and inculcate global values. There has to be added focus on input and process norms rather than mainly the output norms. Due to media implosion, there is wild aggression. There is a need to develop media culture in this media crowd. Rather than the degree of degrees, we need to focus on the flow of knowledge, feelings, and skills. The graduates ought to be strong team builder, creative and critical thinkers and problem solvers, media prosumers, techno-savvy, info-savvy, nature-savvy, innovator, constructor and collaborator, proficient writer, reader, speaker, listener and communicator, self-directed responsible worker, self-realizing global citizen, multilingual, continuous learner. The teacher ought to be fully networked with the family, locale, and community. Sources and media resources, conferences, curriculum documents, social bookmarking, video conferencing, blogs, wikis, podcasts, and social networking sites. The teacher has to be with multiple intelligence, intrapersonal, interpersonal, visual, spatial, musical, linguistic, and logical, mathematical. The teacher ought to be sensitive, knowledgeable, skillful, pioneer, investigator, physical, metaphysical, universal, and spiritual. The teachers should have time and space to grow and develop in the present day culture and environment. Teachers should conduct action research into the education problems and find the possible indigenous solutions through their own sources, resources, and methodology to better their professional quality. For that, the teachers need to be proficient in research and development. Students, now let us see the expectations and expressions from a teacher. A 21st century teachers are expected to be classical cum modern, then backbone of the country, architect of the society, closest to the children, self-confident, inquisitive, faithful, dutiful, simple, and humble, a role model for the learners, promoter of participatory approach, civilized ideal citizens, and above all, friend, philosopher, and guide. A teacher ought to be sincere and hardworking, socially sensitive and professionally committed, autonomous and accountable, and fast renewing. But the tragedy is that at times the teachers feel the void of being a teacher and end up the day in non-teaching activities. Dear students, now let us see the teachers and learners' roles and relationships. In the advent of 21st century, there is a drastic change in the role of teachers. Rather than purveyor of information, the teacher is now more of facilitator of learning experiences by the learners. Rather than storehouse of knowledge, teacher is expected to know the locations of various sites of information. At times, a learner is better informed and skilled than the teacher. So, the 21st century demands more of a personalized system of instruction. Gone are the days when the needs of the learner were limited and static. There are varied learner needs and learning styles. The teacher should be resourceful to ascertain the needs of the learners and accordingly devise the curriculum and modes of transaction. Also, in a class, some are audio learners, some are video learners, some audio-video learners, whereas some are kinesthetic. Some are receivers and accommodators, whereas others are challenging reflectors. The teachers need to match the teaching styles with learning styles. The 21st century teacher is expected to have a highly comprehensive and versatile profile. She is expected to have in-depth knowledge of all the philosophies of education, such as naturalism, idealism, pragmatism, existentialism, Jainism, Buddhism, and Sankhya. Also, the teachers are expected to know child psychology, adolescent psychology, adult psychology, middle age psychology, and old age psychology. She should be deeply rooted in the culture and moral values of the society. She should have thorough knowledge of social norms and value system. A teacher should fully understand the level of convergence of the states, society, and education for healthy survival. Dear students, now let us summarize this entire topic. The 21st century teacher has to be rooted in the foundations and core of education, philosophical, psychological, sociological, historical, futurological and environmental. The teacher should be in a position to devise and develop teacher education curricula and modes of transaction of curricula. For that, the teacher is expected to be info-savvy and techno-pedagogue. Along with up-to-date knowledge base, the teacher ought to be highly skilled and emotionally stable. She should be in a position to easily blend the culture and values of the East and materialism of the West. Howsoever, micro-specialist, the teacher has to be holistic. She has to be subject-sensitive as well as socially sensitive. Our teachers need to be humane and professional. The identity of teacher education needs to be revived. The teacher ought to be continuously aware of the self, evaluate and moderate the self so as to continuously transform the self. The 21st century teacher has to be a dedicated researcher, constructivist and connectionist. We should full stop doubting the credibility and competency of our teachers. We need to evolve and observe input, process, output, placement and promotion norms for teachers. Thank you.